Hi everyone, today we're reviewing an album by the Foo Fighters called Medicine at Midnight. Oh yeah, for those of you that noticed, I changed my intro because I thought Ladies and Gentlemen was a bit of a old-timey thing to say. Now, about the album. It's Medicine at Midnight by the Foo Fighters, it's their latest LP. It has been brought out on the 5th of February 2021. So, just about a year ago. It has 9 tracks and is 36 minutes long. Starting off with the first track, it's Making a Fire. And that's actually a really good one. I really like that one. It has some really nice vocals and some good background vocals and choirs that also complement the song a lot. And for the Foo Fighters, this album is probably the most groovy album that they released to date. And Making a Fire is a prime example of that. And then we have the song Shame Shame, which I do like a bit, but it's not very exciting. It's not a bad song, but you know, it's just, I don't know, it's just a tiny bit boring. Then there's the song Cloud Spotter, which begins with a very heavy riff, and I must say I do like that song. I'd say it's a fairly decent song. Moving on to Waiting on a War, it starts very mellow, and then it goes into a bit more heavy orientated music, but the time it takes for the music to become heavy is too long in my opinion. Then moving on to the title track, it's probably the most boring track out of all the songs that are on this album. You would say like Medicine at Midnight title track, that should be a hard-hitting song, but it totally isn't. I don't know, I don't have any feelings for this song. Then the band picks things back up in pace with No Son of Mine. It starts with a very chuggy riff. I must say I do like that song quite a bit actually. And then there's probably my favorite song from the album, Holding Poison. I really like the cowbell and the overall groove of this song. There's a solo in it that's not very special. It's not fast, it's not complicated, but it complements the song. And that's all there is to it. And then there's Chasing Birds, which is probably my least favorite song of this album. Every time that song comes up, I'll just skip it because I really don't want to sit there 3 minutes and waste my time. And then we're on to the closer, Love Dies Young. I mean, the groove is good. That's it. No, the groove is good. I really like the guitars in it. The lyrics are fine too. I just think it drags on a bit too long. So now, the rating. It was a mixed bag. There are songs that I really liked, and then there are songs that I, yeah, just plain disliked. But I have to say, the good songs outweigh the bad songs, and that's a good thing. So that's why I'll give it a 7 out of 10. Now, I hope you all enjoyed this review. Let me know what you want me to review next. What album, what song, what band, you name it, I'll maybe do it. And then I'll see you all very soon in the next video. Bye-bye.